Hi friends, in the last episode of the English SSLC Orukkam, we were discussing important aspects of the fourth unit. There we focused on the first literary text, that is the beggar and the king, and we familiarized the discourses like a review, character sketch, profiles, letters, etc. And we ended up our discussion with the profile of the poet K. Sachidanandan, and K. Sachidanandan found a place in our textbook to his beautiful poem Cactus, and let us familiarize the poem in detail. So it's a, I told you it is a beautiful poem when all the poets talk about birds, flowers, gardens, valleys and beautiful sceneries and about the romantic world. There are a few poets who talk about the poor, the downtrodden, the marginalized, and like that of the cactus and about the thorns. So when you read the poem Cactus, you should get the gist or the essence of the message of the poem that the poet wanted to convey. Then only you will be able to answer any questions based on this poem. So have an analytical mind while you go through the lines. Let me give you some examples of testing the poem. So go through the poem. It reads like this: thorns are my language, I announce my existence with a bleeding touch. Once these thorns were flowers, I loved lovers who betray. Poets have abandoned the deserts to go back to the gardens. Only camels remain here and merchants who trample my flowers to dust. So you are reading the poem with all your mind and you try to get the answers to the questions. How does cactus announce its existence? So the answer is there in the poem, in the lines: I announce my existence with a bleeding touch. I means, I refers to the cactus. So the cactus announces its existence with a bleeding touch. Answer is clear, it is there. This is how you have to pick out the answers. Then why does cactus hate some lovers? Answer, very simple, is it? Cactus hate some lovers because they betray. Once they betray the cactus, so the cactus hid. What has happened to the flowers of cactus? Read the last lines. Only camels remain here and merchants. In the desert, camels and merchants are remaining, but they trample my flowers to dust. So camels and merchants trample the flowers of cactus. Then why do poets abandon the desert? Of course the answer is there in the lines: poets have abandoned the desert to go back to the gardens. So these are very simple questions, thereby you are able to get answers without any difficulty. So every time you won't be able to get the answers from the directly from the lines. Sometimes more thought, I mean questions demanding more thinking, more you are testing your analytical power, testing your reasoning, testing your critical reading will be available in the evaluation text. So you should read and understand the different meanings of each line, the important implications of expressions, varied implications of the expressions and the words used by the poet. So, what does this particular word indicate? What does this particular expression indicate? Has it got a different meaning? Has it only a factual meaning, or can it has it create any different image? So, such questions you should ask to the each line. Let us see another example. First, let us go to the poem. One thorn for each rare of water. One thorn for each rare drop of water. I don't tempt butterflies. No bird sings my praise. I don't yield to drops. I create neither beauty beyond the moonlight. This side of dreams, a sharp, piercing, parallel language. So, very touching lines, thought provoking lines. Here, some questions. What does the cactus do with every drop of water? Answer is evident. One thorn for each rare drop of water. So, cactus make use of rare drop of water. Why is it rare? Because in desert, water is the rarest commodity. But cactus make use of, cactus represents the have nots, the marginalized. So, they get minimum opportunities, but they make use of it. In the same way here, cactus make use of each rare drop of water and make one thorn from each drop. That is the answer. Then what does the cactus withstand? So, here every year, every season there will be droughts. Droughts in the sense there is no rain, there is no water. So, it is a dry land. So, the cactus is surviving without water, without much food. So, it withstand drought and the dry weather. What does cactus manifest? So, cactus, though it has thorns, though it is not beautiful, it creates neither beauty. So, it creates a beauty beyond the moonlight, this side of dreams, this side of dreams. Usually we talk about dreams, hopes, expectation. That is a world of fantasy, a world of romanticism. Means you can dream of anything.